Hello once again, ladies and gentlemen, from IWA Championship Wrestling.
There are the Mavericks.
They've got the cowboy style. They got the cowboy look. They're real nice.
They're the champions.
Well, I'm trying to be impartial and nice here. And unfortunately, I have a loss for words when it comes to this.
I had no desire to be impartial. I was calling it like Steve.
Well, that's your prerogative, just like I've got my prerogative.
And ladies and gentlemen, as I said before, there are your tag team heavyweight champions.
They're definitely the champions, and from my understanding, they've had them tag team titles for quite some time now, haven't they?
Oh, yeah.
Excuse me?
They're unbeatable.
Well, I wouldn't say they're unbeatable. You know, one time I thought I was unbeatable. I'm sure you think you're unbeatable at your job, but I'm sure there's somebody out there that could replace you.
don't have me that kind of crap, buddy.
Hey, I only call it as I see it.
I call that the deal. Some people don't like the truth.
Okay.
From Thomasville, North Carolina, these are the Terminators.
Taking the place of Terminator number 2 tonight, and this is a title match, will be Mr. Excellent.
Oh, I think.
Well,
I'm sure there's an extremely good reason why Terminator number 2 is not here. I have never seen Terminator number 2 back down from anything, trust me. He never backed down from me.
Well, you're not the Mavericks, are you?
No, I'm not the Mavericks.
Well, there you go.
And I'm glad I'm not the Mavericks. See, what really bothers me about the Mavericks is that they are real good inside the ring wrestling. But they stoop to the level of
winning.
You call it winning, I just doubt that. Call it cheating.
Well, that's called the winner.
Okay, as far as Terminator number 1 goes, I know he's had the tag team championships, him and Terminator number 2. That's correct.
And here we go, Mr. Excellent against the Maverick. I believe this is Buck, isn't it?
I'm not sure you're going to have to help me with this, but I believe this could be Buck. Nice high air.
Whoa.
Shoulder block.
Good move. Another good move.
Couldn't get out of the way on those. Headlock, takeover. I wonder how I knew that was going to happen. It's a headlock takeover.
Well, you've been in those holes so many times now, we've been knocked on the back a whole lot. So I guess you know what's coming up next.
Well, I was flat on my back one time. And see, this is what I'm talking about. You're going straight to the double teaming right here. Way too early in the match.
No, it's tag team wrestling.
That's
tag
correct.
Team wrestling.
It's tag
two
team.
People.
Tag team, that's correct. Two people. Terminator number 1 needs to stay back. I knew this was going to happen. I am surprised that both of the Mavericks are not on Mr. Excellent.
Oh, Mr. Excellent with
Mr. That's correct. I believe I called him Mr. Excellent, but he is Mr. Excellent, and he is an excellent wrestler.
Whoa.
Nice knee to the midsection.
Yeah.
Elbow to the back of the head. That will either knock some sense into you or knock your sense with you.
Well, with Mr. Excellent, we can't tell which one.
But he does have a pretty hard head, because me and him bumped heads a few times. 1, 2, 3. And he gives it a break. What are we doing here? Nice hip toss. Nice hip toss. Not understanding exactly what Mr. Excellence was trying to do with that maneuver, but whatever it was, it worked.
Well, you got to remember one thing also, is that Mr. Excellent and the Terminator, as far as I know,
double clothesline.
That was a good move.
Here we go. One,
You're not going to pin him that easy.
No, it's awful early in the match.
But as far as I know, these two have never tagged up before. So that is going to eventually come into play in this match.
Well, I have to agree.
I have to give the Terminator credit. They are some excellent wrestlers. But, of course, Terminator number two is, as we say, not here tonight.
Now, if you'll notice, we got him in the corner, and here we go. Mr. Turning the favor. Yep. Just returning the favor.
Well,
that's all you can say. There's no doubt in my mind. Had they not double-teamed him, he would have never done that.
No, I disagree. Tag team wrestling means two.
Yeah, two on one. It's supposed to be 2-on-2. You've got a choke in the corner. You've got him teaming up on him here in the corner. That wasn't a pin. That wasn't a tag. They just switched out.
Well, if the referee's busy up here with the Terminator, that's his own
fault.
This
is going to be a double suplex. Yeah. Now, that's three times the weight coming down on the small of your back.
That was an excellent move by Mr. Rashley.
I can't believe that. One, two, three.
Hey, yeah. What do you say that, Tommy?
The Mavericks win the first fall. This is a 2 out of 3 fall match. The match continues.
Okay. I didn't have no advance warning on this 2 out of 3 fall match. And I tell you, I'm glad to see that it is best 2 out of 3. And here we go again where the Terminator number 2 and Mr. Excellence are not the same people. And Terminator number 1 and Mr. Excitement, Mr. Excellence, excuse me, they've got to jail together as tag team partners.
And they don't have time to do that.
You are correct.
Without Terminator number 2, this is going to be a weak point in their match.
But now,
whoa, Mr. Excellent, serious right hand.
Coming straight out with fist to cuff. He's not wasting no time.
Into
getting straight down to business.
Oh, what
nice spin! Nice spin around leg kick.
Whoa.
Straight to the head.
And Mr. Excellent is
driving
a great
that knee,
wrestler.
Driving that knee down into the shoulder.
He might be a great wrestler, but I don't consider him excellent because to be excellent, you got to have a title, in my opinion. Otherwise, you're almost excellent.
So you're saying that you're not quite excellent yet?
Oh, I'm not a wrestler. I'm not a wrestler.
But you don't have a title there.
I'm an announcer. I don't need a title.
Well, I tell you what, if you was that great of an announcer, let's see, here we go. Over the top rope.
What?
Over the top rope.
What?
And the way I have it figured, it's, what's that?
One to one.
That's correct, Mr. Referee. It is one fall. We already knew that.
Did you see what happened there? The Terminator jumped over the top rope just so he could get a fall count towards him. Right.
Well,
the Terminators have won the second fall. It's 1-1.
Jumping and being pushed is that when you jump, nobody's around you. And as you plainly see, the Mavericks threw him over.
When he landed, I didn't see anybody around him.
When he landed on the concrete, no, there wasn't nobody around.
Well, I don't agree with it. He jumped over the top rope. Here we go, the third fall.
Let's see
the Terminator
here.
Terminator against the Maverick. Come on. What's going on, boy, huh? And Mr. Ashton there just hanging out, trying not to get in the way.
Nice leg takedown. Drop the leg right across the knee, going to the outside of the rope. I do not blame the Terminator. I would be upset. They threw him over the top rope. I would be using anything that I possibly could, including the steel ring post. Boy, I tell you what, that will cause you not to have no children for the rest of your life.
That was a dirty, cheap shot by the Terminator.
That's no dirty cheaper than throwing him over the top rope.
He jumped over the top rope so he could get a pinfall. That's all it was. A pinfall, he didn't get pinned. But you know, that's a cheap way to get around.
And there you go. He's staying on him. He gets back into the ring, stays on him. Burn up that chest. Burn up that chest, Terminator number one. Straight to the top of the head. Another, let's see. Oh, yes. When we can hear the chops over here, you know they've got some power behind them.
I would not want to be in that ring.
I believe the Maverick don't know where he's at because, if I'm not mistaken, he was trying to tag in Mr. Excellent.
Sort of seemed like it. And Mr. Excellent, well, here he comes. As I said earlier,
twisted on that arm. That.
Mr. Ashton,
now let me ask you something. What would you call that move, AJ?
I have no idea what was it.
Well, if you don't know, I'm not going to tell you. Me and the fans at home know exactly what it was.
Well, Tommy,
the bottom line is Mr. Excellence is on top and got a front chin lock.
Choking right now.
No, that is no choke. That is no choke. But he needs to stick. I was getting ready to say he needs to stick to the wrestling in the ring and not messing with the crowd. And this right here is what happens when you take your mind off from what you're doing.
Well, he does that a lot.
Well, evidently, I've seen it in two matches tonight.
Yeah, you see, he's used to being a singles wrestler.
What do we have here? Now that is what I call a blatant chokehold when you take something out of your pants. Looks like rope or tape or some type of... Bottom line is, AJ, you seen that it was a foreign object around Mr. Excellence's throat.
Yeah, but Tommy, whoa!
But as you can tell, it did not take all the punch out of Mr. Excellence.
But,
wonderful African-American
wrestler. What I'm trying to tell you is, if I see it or you see it, it doesn't matter. The bottom line is that the referee does not see it. Right, Lee Terminator, distracting the referee and giving the Mavericks plenty of opportunity.
Well, that's where as a tag team, you've got to understand you can't keep the referee's attention on your side of the ring. You've got to let the referee do his job. And for some reason, and he's going back in. He needs to stay on the outside and let the referee do his job.
I'm one of the Terminator hadn't been paid off to make sure Mr. Ashton gets hurt.
Now, that's a wonderful reversal, I tell you what, there's no way you or anybody else can make me believe that the Terminator's been paid off.
Well, look at him, he's distracting the referee.
He is distracting. I do not understand why he's distracting the referee. I wished I could explain that, but I cannot. A rake to the eyes. From the outside, the Maverick is standing on the outside of the ring and blatantly raked the eyes of Mr. Excellence.
And how did that move happen? Because the Terminator distracted the referee.
What did that have to do with the rake to the eyes?
The referee did not see it, did not
if
talk.
If you're going to cheat, you're going to cheat. That's the bottom line.
And I'm seriously wondering, what side? Look at the Terminator again, interfering in the match. Allow Mr. Ashton to do it.
But did you see the dust under?
Oh,
and come back with a double
clothesline.
Come back with a double clothesline. And have got both Mavericks, not one AJ, but both Mavericks on the mat.
Just one moment.
And what are we doing here? That was a clean tag.
Well, the referee didn't see it. It doesn't count. It does not count.
Unfair advantage. Unfair advantage. Totally.
That's because Mr. Ashton and the Terminator are not tag team partners. Boom!
Well, that is true.
One,
don't ever pin him here.
Three, four.
No, I told you. You counted four. I barely counted one and a half.
Well, that's because you count.
And you got to go in and save your partner. Here we go.
What is this?
One, two.
Mr. Excellent
I thought Mr. Excellent had it with the action going over here into the far corner. Nice job by the Maverick. See what happens here. Reverse.
Oh,
runs
no.
them together. Runs them together. Small package. Double small package. One, two, three.
What?
And if I'm not mistaken, that is the match.
Look
who comes out with their hands raised high. It sure wasn't the Mavericks.
That's it. I can't believe it, but they did win.
Here are your winners, Terminator number one and Mr. Excellent.
Mr. Excellent and Terminator number one takes the titles away.
Wait a minute. Mr. Ashley, you are not one of the Terminators. So who does that belt go to?
So what we got going on here?
What is this?
I do not understand.
What is going on?